Hey guys, my name is Sammy. I'm a classical Pilates teacher, and today is a tutorial on the footwork series done on the Reformer. It's the first exercise in the Pilates order that Joe Pilates created. I have legacy equipment here, very heavy springs, and if you have non-classical equipment, you can still do the classical exercises. Just know that you need heavy springs, and depending on your strength and your size, ideally four, but you can go down to three if you need to, or if you have an injury of some kind that is going to make you go down. Okay, so to get on, there's a few different ways. You are standing at the diagonal and you're very close to the edge. You're going to draw those arms into your sides, draw the stomach in and up, slide the arms down, and sit onto the very corner edge of the Reformer. I have half of my butt cheek off. Okay, from there, you lie onto your side, and then you roll onto your back, and you position yourself with your shoulders against the shoulder blocks and your feet onto the foot bar. Okay, I'm gonna show you that again, nice and smooth. To more advance getting on, your arms will genie, pushing one arm into the other to activate more body parts. Draw the stomach in and up and sit down. That was a little too far out. But you'll then do the same thing. Another awesome way to get on that I have actually recently learned and I want to share with you because I really like it is before you're sitting on the edge, so you have room to roll to your side and lie onto your back. This time you're on the edge, but your butt's more in the middle of the Reformer if you're lying down, the middle this way, okay? And you're gonna put your hand down next to your hip, and then you're gonna swing your legs up and swing your hand, the other hand down to grab the front of the carriage. What I like about this is now I can see where to put my feet. This can be quite challenging. It's a little more advanced to sit up and do this. You pull your feet in and you put your feet onto the Reformer and then you lie all the way down and you're there. Okay, a couple things that I want to make known. General rule of thumb is you start in a Pilates stance. That's heels together, toes apart, about 2 to 3 fingers, or you can think of it as a very narrow first position if you are a dancer or know about dance. You wanna make sure your pinky toes are on. You're gluing those heels together and then you press out from here and you come back in. What you want to think about when you press out is not slamming the knees down and sinking in the backs of the knees, but you're actually trying to stretch the springs of the Reformer to push the back of the Reformer all the way to the back edge. And then you lift the knees and you come back in. So you're pressing, you're lengthening the quad, lengthening the front of the hip, and then you come back in. Some common things that happen is to press out and squeeze the butt and lift the butt this way instead of staying down and lengthening and coming back in. So that's something to, you know, keep note of when you're working. The other thing is you want your heels to ideally stay still. So imagine that this foot bar continued and it was one solid piece. And actually, Kathy Ross Nash, she's a brilliant Pilates instructor, she actually created a board that goes right there for the heels. So if you imagine that your heels are pushing into that board with the exact amount of pressure that your toes are pushing into the foot bar, you have now activated all the backside of your body. So the heels are still held accountable the whole time. And keeping the heels still, easier said than done, it doesn't have to be perfect, but the more that you try, the more work you're gonna feel in your body. So that's kind of nice. Okay, now, if you are bow-legged, like I am, which means that when your legs are straight, the knees don't touch, it's just very slight, then a greater turnout might be better for you because it's harder to find the inner thighs when nothing is touching together. So the best way to find that is to bring your feet together, just like this in a prayer position, and put the middle of your foot on that foot bar. Now you're gonna keep the heels together and you're gonna rotate the toes open and place them on the foot bar. Not all your toes will be on this time. You're gonna glue those heels together. You're
pushing the heels in and opening the knees out. And now you're going to press out and zip up those inner thighs and come back. This is a much better way for me because it automatically makes me find the muscles that I need to find. And the more that you can find them without guessing, the better, because then you'll just be doing the work properly. Now, if you are knock-kneed, which means your knees knock in, you want to stay parallel. So you're going to go to where your knees are in line with your hips, and your feet will probably be wider than that. Maybe you have to press out to find it, though, because when your knees are bent, everything can align properly usually. But when you go out is when they knock in. So this is where you're going to want to look, make sure you're in the center and that your hips are in line with your knees, so your feet will probably be wider. I'm not knock-kneed, so it's kind of hard for me to show, but I do have a video about this that I'll post somewhere up here just in case you are knock-kneed and you want to make sure you're working out correctly for your body. So that's what you will do. Okay, then you have the option just be together parallel. Sometimes that is better for people. You have to kind of play around and see what's best for you. All right, so toes, it goes toes, arches, heels, tendon stretch for the whole series, 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay, so whatever position you pick, there's 10 of them on your toes. Moving on to the next part is arches. So now that, you know, in our book, when we first learn, it says bird on a perch, because you want to make sure that you're not just pushing the ball of the foot over and losing the heel, and you're not just sinking the heel under and losing the ball of the foot. So you do want to keep that bird on a perch the whole time. And generally what wants to happen when you're on your arches is you press out and the heels come down, and then you come in and the heels lift. This is just kind of a natural thing that occurs. And I love to challenge my clients with keeping the feet still. Easier said than done, of course. But it's not about perfection, it's about trying. So anyways, you find your position a little bit. Some people are still here. You do have four arches, but let's go back a little bit closer to the heel. And now when you press out, you want to still push the ball of the foot over just enough so that it doesn't move. Not so much that you overcorrect and the foot moves forward, just enough so that it doesn't go naturally back this way. And then when you come in, the heels now have to kind of wrap under a little bit more so that they don't lift, okay? So you press it out and you come back and you push out, you push through that ball of the foot. Basically, you want to always be feeling the ball of the foot and the heel being held accountable, not letting either of them down. Press it out and come back. Your tailbone stays heavy. There's 10 of these as well. Out and come back. And out and come back. Good. Now let's go on to the heels. So you still want the ball of your foot to be held accountable. So remember when we imagined that there was a bar that went across here that our heels could press into? Now imagine that the ball of your foot is pressing in, and then you're pulling the toes back. All right, so now you want the heel pushing in, and that's going to engage the backs of your legs, and then the ball of the foot forward is going to engage more of the front body, okay? So now press through the heels to go out, but without letting the ball of the foot pull backwards, and then come back in and press. And back. And you should, mine was probably rocking there because I just got distracted in what I'm going to tell you next, but you're trying your best to keep them from moving. I find it very challenging. So it's 10 toes, 10 arches, 10 heels, and now it's 10 tendon stretches. So whatever position you want to choose again, parallel, you know, basically whatever you chose on your toes, you can do here as well. You can also go into that wide stance. However, for me, I really like to be in more of a narrow Pilates stance for this one. And then you're going to press out until those legs are straight. Remember, if you're feeling it heavy in the backs of the legs, it's because you're sinking into them. So you're going to draw the stomach in and up, glue your heels together, and lengthen through the front of the hip and the quad, not your knees. And you're going to lower down three and two and one and up three and two and one and lower three and two and one and up three and two and one and go down and down and down and lift and lift and lift. And you can change up the rhythm here. You can go down three, two, one, up on one, or down on one with control and up three and two and one. You'll lift the knees and come in. Okay, so just a little tips here that if you are having trouble finding, you or a client, are having trouble finding the way in without riding the springs, because this tends to happen where you go out and you're all engaged and then you relax and you just ride the springs in. The springs give you resistance on the way out. It is your job to then resist them on the way in, and that can be kind of hard to find, and it starts with not losing the connection. So one thing that I really like to do to help people with that is to go out, come in about an inch. I'm on my toes right now. You can do this in all the foot positions, but to just come in, plug that, before we start, pull that thigh into the hip socket, and you're going to come in an inch and out an inch, in an inch. And your job is that when you come in an inch, that you're not relaxing. You are staying completely engaged the exact same way the whole time. Out an inch, in an inch, and then maybe you make it 2 inches and out, and 2 inches and out. And you can make it a little bigger. I also sometimes like to do this all on two or one spring if I'm really going to pick on something so that it's not so heavy and they can focus on maybe keeping the engagement in the body. So anyways, let's do the footwork series. You pick which position you want. Remember, it's 10, 10, 10, 10. And let's go. On your toes, drawing that stomach in 10 times, 10, and come back. Think out, 2, 3, in, 2, 3. You really want to try not to stop the carriage. You're not rushing. You're just constantly moving. 2, 3, out. 2, 3, in, 2, 3, out, 2, 3, in, 2, 3. Let's go four more, four, breathing, 3, 2, stay connected, 1, you come in and you quickly go to your arches, out, 2, 3, in, 2, 3, out, 2, 3, in, 2, 3, and you're really stretching the springs versus slamming the knees down. Stretch back, stretch back, stretch back. The knees do go down, but they go down because you're stretching the carriage so far back. Make sure you're holding the ball of your foot and your heel accountable. Let's do two more. One more. And go to your heels. Out, 2, 3, in, 2, 3. Push the ball of the foot and through your heel. 7, 6, 5, 4, close the carriage, 3, 2, oh, my feet are rocking, you do better than me, 1, tendon stretch, pick your position, press it out, down, 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 up, up, up. Good. Now let's go down 3, up 1. Pull that stomach in a little deeper, in and up. Down, 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 and up. Down, 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 and up. One more. Now let's go down on 1. Make sure it's with control. Lift up to go down. Up, up, up. Down on 1. Take it up, up, up. Down on 1. Take it up, up, up. Down, up, up, up. Now 3 down, 3 up. 2 more times. Down, down, down. Up, up, up. One more. Lift, lift the knees, come all the way in. Let's learn the transition into the 100. The more you know the transitions, the more exercises you can get done in a session, the more cardio you'll get because you spend less time fussing with your equipment and more time working out. It also helps you remember what comes next, okay? So you just did footwork, next is the 100. My foot bar can be lowered with my feet. So I will hook one foot under, lift the bar, catch it with my other foot, and lower down. When you are doing that, you really want to pull the stomach in, because letting it go out, you're going to get into your lower back in a bad way, and that's not very great, okay?
Now, some foot bars lock into place, and you're not going to be able to lower it with your feet.
So what you do in that situation, oh my word, my hair. So what you'll do in that situation is bring your knees into your chest, rock up. In a perfect world, you are keeping your feet up, and then you'll lower your foot down, your foot bar down, swing back, and lie down. If you have to rest your feet there to do it, then that's also fine. You're gonna work your way up to constantly working through your transition so that you are really working the entire time you're doing your Pilates workout with not resting. Okay, so now, if you can lower it with your feet, you do want to try to also grab your handles at the same time. Again, it's all about getting the transitions done quickly and efficiently to continue moving on with your workout. So as I hook a foot under, stomach's in and up, I grab the handles, I lift up, catch it, lower down, drawing my stomach in even deeper, straightening my legs, and now I am ready for the 100. Okay? So all of that takes practice and timing. I'm going to flow through that transition,
starting with, through both of those, sitting down. I'm just going to do like one of each of the footworks and move on into the transition to the 100. Okay?
Okay.
All right, you guys, that was your footwork series on the Reformer. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. And I'll see you next time for something that has to do with Pilates. Have a great day, you guys. Bye.